Sangsu hadanmaki, sangsu sangdanmaki. Hands come to my hip. Step into a front stance. I crisscross my arms at the wrist. Turning my hip, when my arms get to the center, they come straight down. So again, my arms are from the side. I twist my body. When I approach, turning at the center, my arms go straight down. It's not straight down by itself, it's straight down with the twist. To do the high X block, I don't just go like this, and I don't just go like this. I go like this. I twist again, and I bring my hands into my solar plexus, and as I approach the middle, the arms come up. Two night hands, nice and tight. So, when I do the next one, I switch them, cross, step, twist in the block. Notice how once I approach the center, that's when they fire downward. And then I pull it back. As my hands get here, I open them up and fire them out. So, low X block, high X block. Sangsu hadanmaki. Sangsu sangdanmaki. Turning of the hips. Sangsu hadanmaki. Sangsu sangdanmaki. From the side. Cross with the twist. Step. Lock. Twist. Lock. Cross and twist. Step. Lock. Pull it back. Block. Low X block, high X block. Here we go. So many people get confused on spear hand. So when I do a spear hand is not a ridge hand. It's not a knife hand, okay? It's like a punch, but with your fingers pointing out. So many people do their spear hands that are like this. That's not a spear, that's more like a bad chop. So a spear hand by itself is like a punch, except with the points of my fingers. So, for those that have a hard time with this, let's do that a few times. Make your fist, and then you're going to open your fingers. I think sometimes we need to break it down like that. So right now I'm aiming at the solar plexus, so my palm is facing to the side. Pull it back, now we're going to aim to the throat. So now my fingers are pointing down. Notice how tight I keep my fingers together. And I'll do that more in a second. Notice I'm not doing anything with this hand yet. Because that hand does do something. So, throat, solar plexus, groin, palm is up. Throat, solar plexus, groin. Throat, solar plexus, groin, other hand, so I'm here. In Korean, this is Kwansu Kung Kyo. So, when we do it in the line drill, we typically step in a front stance. We do this parry motion. A lot of people don't understand what the purpose of this hand is. Okay? If you're attacking me, I'm parrying that attack downward and then firing my spear hand over top of that. So from the side, here, and here. Elbow and wrist. So again, notice the hand is here, because I'm not going to go like I'm going to shake somebody's hand. So what this parry is doing is clearing the obstacle out of the way so I can step through with that spear hand. Okay? This is what I want everybody to do with their hands. Okay? This is kind of bad, but at least it's not this. I see people sometimes do spear hands like this. Like, what are you doing there? All right? First of all, they have to be together. Think of like a point of an arrow or a point of a spear. Okay? So when you do this, fingers are together, thumb is tucked in. Now, watch. I'm going to bend my two longer fingers so that my fingers are almost all the same length. And I let them overlap a little bit if they need to. So now I have a little bit better of a striking weapon. So I'm not like this, flat, but I'm actually curling everything so that when I hit, I'm hitting with more of a flat side weapon. Okay? If you ever hit anything hard with a spear hand, you'll know. Okay? It doesn't feel pleasant. But you're not really supposed to hit something hard like somebody's head. You're supposed to hit soft targets. But you still need to hold your fingers a specific way. Alright? So, spear hand attack. Parry. Step. Fire it straight through. I'm aiming at the solar plexus. I'm not up here. I'm not over here. I'm not here. I'm here. From the side. Parry. Step. Parry. I'm pulling this hand back. Step. Parry. Pull this hand back.